Oh, the percent rules. The 50% rule, the 1% rule, and the 2% rule. We all know them, we all love them, or we all hate them, which, you know, or you know nothing about what I'm talking about, so we're going to explain it. So if you start looking into rental properties specifically, people have come up with over the years these rules. And the rules are intended to give you an idea of whether or how well a property is going to cash flow or not. So the 50% rule says that you can look at the income of a property, like the rental income per month, and assume 50% of that is going to go towards expenses and 50 is going to go into your pocket. What does that number turn out to be? And so it's like, well, what's that 50% that's going to end up in my pocket? And there's my cash flow. Or the 1% or 2% rules say that if the monthly rental amount is 1% of the purchase price or 2% of the purchase price, that you're going to be looking at positive cash flow. Back in the day when you could get properties so much cheaper, the 2% rule was actually really easy to find, and it was amazing. And everyone was like, I want a 2%. And chances are, if it fit the 2% bill, it probably was going to cash flow, not only cash flow, but probably cash flow pretty well. Nowadays, most people are lucky to get to 1%, depending on what kind of properties you're working with. For turnkey rental properties, you're doing good if you get a 1% property, meaning the monthly rent is at least 1% of the purchase price. Now, here's why I hate those rules. Hate them. They are fantastic if, and this is the only purpose I think they serve, if you have a big inventory of properties in front of you and you're scrolling through them, you can pretty quickly apply a rule to it and narrow down your list. So like, oh, that's a 1% property. Oh, 50%. Yeah, like that. Okay, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. That should be the end of the rules. The rules are really just guidelines. So first of all, they're misnamed, so it's misleading. But here's where the problem is that I think comes in with those rules, is especially in turnkey world, because in turnkey world, all of the properties, if you come to me and say, hey, I want to be a turnkey rental property, show me your inventory, I'm going to shove all this inventory to you. And the thing is that all of the properties I give to you are cash flowing, because that's how turnkeys work. They come from turnkey providers who only work with cash flowing rental properties. So that's very different than if you're an individual investor who has to scour through the MLS, for example, because you don't know on the MLS if anything is cash flowing. So in that case, maybe you could use one of the rules, 50% or 1% or whatever, to narrow down your list. But if I hand you a turnkey inventory and I say, what do you like? There's no real point in using any of those rules, because we already know that the properties are cash flowing. And then, so first of all, they don't make a lot of sense for turnkeys, for starters. But here's the problem. People over the years have taken these rules to be rules, and they have it in their head that if it meets the 50% rule or the 1% rule, 2% also, but we don't have that one as much, that it's going to cash flow. Here's the problem in that. You're estimating. It's not a guarantee it's going to cash flow. So let's say that you buy a 1% property in Texas where Texas has really high insurance and property tax amounts. Well, your 1% there may not really give you a whole lot of cash flow because of those external factors. Because the rules, I keep using air quotes, the rules don't take into account the actual expenses. So if you're in a low expense state or it's a low expense property or whatever, sure, the rules may work out fine. But if you naively buy a 1% property in a high expense area, high property taxes, high insurance, this may be Florida, it could be Texas, certainly California, but there's no cash flow there anyways, then you may not be getting the result that you think you are. And what I've seen these rules tell people over the years is that it's okay to estimate. Don't estimate your numbers. You should never estimate your numbers. Again, you can do it if you're just trying to narrow down your shopping list off the MLS or wherever. But with turnkeys, the list is already narrowed down. They're all cash flowing. So you need to be focusing on actual numbers. What are the actual property taxes? You can get that from the county's tax assessor website. What's the actual insurance rate? Get an insurance quote. What is the rent? What's your mortgage going to be? You know, the only expenses you should be estimating are maintenance and vacancy, because you can't obviously predict those perfectly. property management fees, HOA, utilities, all of those are known. So you need to be working with the known actual numbers, which at that point, because then you use the known actual numbers to calculate your actual cash flow. Forget a rule, man. Like, it, that doesn't tell you anything, and it's not a guarantee to cash flow. So if you're using those rules, you know, it's a bad practice. As a real estate investor, you should never be estimating anything that you don't have to estimate, and never rely on a rule, because it's not a rule. It's simply a guideline, and it's really only to be used for shopping. So if you have any questions on the 1% or 2% rule, I have a couple articles about it. I will share those. But, and honestly, the 50% rule, never one time in my real estate investing career have I ever used that rule. I may not even told you correctly what it is. That's how little I know about it, because I don't care, because I think that is even less accurate than the 1% and 2% rules as far as like determining anything. So my vote is steer clear of them unless you're just doing an initial round of shopping. But after that, get rid of those rules, because they're going to get you in trouble, and they're also potentially going to rule you out of really good properties. I've seen a lot of people that say, I only want a turnkey if it hits the 1% rule. And I'm like, I mean, I see where you're going with that, but that doesn't mean that that property is going to cash flow more than another, or maybe a property that hits like 0.85% is actually a substantially better deal. So don't dictate your investing by those rules at all, because they don't tell you reality at all.